Having said that, let's move to our second topic, that is the major targets of promotional campaigns. Any promotional activity is usually designed with a specific target audience in mind. The activity is therefore created using messages, cues, and information that they will respond to. Realistically, the major portion of any promotional budget is aimed at this specific targeted audience. However, there may be important fringe groups who may have an influence over the intended target or stake in the product. Some of these fringe groups may include, the first being the actual audience. These are the current customers of the product, as well as former customers and any potential new customers. This activity is created for these people specifically. That is, the promotional activities are generally and wholly focused on reaching out to the actual audience. Second being the influencers. People or organizations that may have their own sphere of influence over the target audience make up this category. If a positive impact is made on these people, they may then use this influence to encourage the sales further. The media, opinion leaders, trade association, and special interest groups are some of these influencers. These are not the people who directly purchase or consume the product, but they actually help in enhancing the sales and in providing better and positive information and image out to the end consumers. Next being the distribution channel members. The product is handled and provided to the customer through the channel making them an important category of the targets. A retailer may choose to display a certain product in a more prominent position than others if he really believes in the product and its benefits. As already spoken in the previous session, there are various kinds of channel members and middlemen who can be involved, from wholesalers to the retailers to the agents to the brokers. These people play a very instrumental role in influencing the sales and the profits for a particular product or a company. If the wholesalers and retailers really believe in the product, they, from their own initiative, would be ready to undertake the promotional activities. As said, they would position certain products in a much better way. Their salespeople in the retail counters would push the particular product forward to the consumers when the consumer doesn't have any specific brand or any specific competition in mind. Next being other companies. Communicating with other companies may open up opportunities to collaborate for the joint ventures. Having said that, let's understand a very important thing, that is the various tools of promotion. There are four major tools of promotion, being advertisement, sales promotion, public relation, and direct marketing, which basically constitutes of personal selling. Let's understand each one of this in brief over here, and in the future session we shall take up each of this in further detail. Advertising. This is a paid form of non-personal presentation and promotion of ideas, goods, and services by an identified sponsor. That is, the seller or the manufacturer has to pay for this kind of promotion, and it does not have a personal touch with the end user or the consumer. This can be used in various media, for example, newspapers, TV, magazines, hoardings, posters, etc. The second is sales promotion. This refers to the short-term use of incentives or other promotional activities that stimulate the customers to buy the particular product. This yet again involves a series of types, that is, consumer promotional activities, dealer promotional activities, and other promotional activities. Anything from rebates to discounts to sale purchase coupons to displays, etc. Third being public relation, popularly known as PR. This is the practice of managing the spread of information between an individual or an organization, such as a business, government agency, or a non-profit organization, and the public. This is an activity which is not paid by directly by the company, but by taking care of the other specialist experts. And finally, direct marketing, that is personal selling. This means selling personally or getting in touch with the consumers on a one-to-one basis. This involves face-to-face interaction between the seller and buyer for the purpose of sale. This is our zero level channel of marketing, which we've already spoken, wherein the consumer and the seller gets in touch directly without any middlemen in between. This has a personal touch to itself and plays a very important role in influencing and motivating the buyers.